Hey guys, it's Mark Spector Comics, and I'm back. Wanted to do a little bit of some recent comic book pickups and some flea market finds. Before you get into it, don't forget to like, hit the subscribe button, and most of all, share those masks. Oh man. You know how it is. In tough times, you gotta have a little bit of laughter with the whole COVID-19 outbreak going on. So, found that to be pretty funny. Hopefully you guys aren't out there stockpiling up on toilet paper, because there's better things you should be honestly picking up instead. But, I haven't really been able to put up a lot of content most recently, and it's honestly because my job and my, you know, hospital have been preparing quite a bit for the coronavirus. So here are some of the books I picked up within the last couple of weeks, and then I will talk a little bit about some flea market finds. All right, guys. So we'll start with the recent pickups. All right, the first book was King of Nowhere number one. This was the cover B. I wasn't able to get the FOC cover variant, which was just an amazing, amazing like Jim Steranko-esque cover. But I was happy that I was able to get the book nonetheless. The story was really good. Basically, this guy was, felt like he was tripping on acid and ended up in this world called Nowhere. But ended up being, you know, reality. So kind of interested to see where this next story goes. Picked up Flash number 750. This was the 1940s, I believe, Niccolo Scott cover. Yep. Haven't yet read it, but I had to pick it up because it was the 750. So, interested to see. The next book was, Hellfire Quinn number one. And this was, if you look at the bottom here, the sneak preview advanced reader copy. So this was actually free. And I think it had about 20, 22 pages worth of story. And this was a really good read. If you like, basically, like Street Fighter, Mortal Kombat, Dragon Ball Z, like the whole tournament fighting type of style, I think you'll really appreciate it. Interested to see where the story goes from there. But I liked it. It was nonstop action. Definitely worth the read if you haven't already read it. As for this week's books, I didn't get a chance to make new comic book day best bets of the week, but it was a very light week, at least for me. I'm sure a lot of other people would agree, but I only picked up three books. I'll go through those fairly quickly. Haven't read the stories yet, but so, first book, and it's because I have this on poll, it's Immortal Hulk, number 32. Really cool Alex Ross cover. You see the Hulk there ripping through the dollar bill. And you got, I think it's a Zemo in the back. Nice, nice cover. And this is issue number 749 for Hulk. The next one's going to be the big 750. It's going to be, hopefully, a huge reveal. The story's been getting really good. So I'm excited to read this. Next book was a few people had this as one of their top picks this week. And this was from Action Labs. This was Sweetheart number one. Low print. Love this really creepy black cover. And the story itself actually went with it. It was a very dark, creepy story. Like the artwork. And I was surprised I was able to pick it up. This was the last one on the shelves. I'm going to have to rebag it because there was a little bit of a rip here on the bag when I bought it. But no big deal. The book itself is in decent shape. And then the hot book of the week, which I was really surprised to pick up, was Hell Arisen number 3, the second print. I wasn't able to get the first print when it came out, but I was happy my shop actually got one of these so I can actually read it and read the story on Punchline. interested to see where the punchline character goes. I know it's going to continue on in the Batman series with the upcoming Joker War. So, nonetheless, I was happy to pick this up because this second print's significantly lower print. And I believe they're already going to third print with Batman 89 and Hell Arisen number 3. They didn't have Batman 89 there, which was too bad. But I was happy to get that nonetheless. So, going on to the... since the last 2 weeks for me was rather light, I had the opportunity to go doing a little bit of driving around in my area within, 10-15 minutes from my place. And I found this really cool, antique thrift shop, 5-10 minutes from my place. And they had some really cool, books there. And the area itself inside was a lot bigger than I thought it would be. And... basically, a lot of the books there were very cheap. Quite a bit of variety from new stuff to 50s, 60s, going back to Archie, Betty and Veronica, all that stuff, Charlton, Golden Key, all that cool stuff. So I'm going to show some of the books I got there, and then I'll show a really cool, what I call the flea market find of the week. All right, guys. So start with the first book. This book's been picking up a little bit of steam, just a little bit, This is Amazing Fantasy number 7. There's a lot of firsts in this book. I want to say it's the first appearance here of the new Scorpion, Carmilla Black. It's also the first appearance of Monica Rappacini. She's a scientist supreme of AIM and the mother of Carmilla. And it's going to be appearing in the MODOK upcoming Disney Plus series. This book has a rather low print run. I want to say around 22,000. So I was happy to get this book there, and I paid only 75 cents. It's not a near mint copy by any means. There's some, creases and whatnot here on the side, but it was only 75 cents. Key collector saying it's around a $10 to $12 book in near mint. So regardless, it's a nice pickup. The next book I got was, Rise of the Midnight Suns. This is the Morbius number 1, the one-shot. Not the one-shot, his first ongoing title. And as you can see, still in the poly bag. Some of these books you may have seen if you were on Superior's live channel the other day, but I'm guessing most people weren't able to watch it live, so it went on for a long time, so I'm just going to show some of these again. Two copies. Picked these up for 75 cents, which I was pretty happy about. For some reason, I've been getting pretty lucky and getting these up on the regular, so that was cool. Next book. This was actually, I went to a different thrift store, these next two books. This is, I don't think anything significant by any means, but this is Fantastic Four, number 573, and it's from the, Jonathan Hickman writing. So, me personally, never been a big Fantastic Four fan, but, I picked this book up for a quarter, and it's in great shape. So that was cool. The book that I got there that I was more happy to pick up was this Fantastic Four number 353. Really cool cover there. I believe there is some significance to this book. Just going to have to look this up real quick. And I think it's been picking up a little bit of steam. I don't know if it has something to do with the Omniverse here. But, oh, that's right. It has to do with the Time Variance Authority, TVA, that they've been talking quite a bit a lot for the upcoming Phase 4. So the significance of this book is the first appearance of Mr. Mobius, which I believe is this character right here. He's the chairman of the TVA. There's been some, set leak photos showing that Owen Wilson with a mustache, just as Mobius is depicted in the actual story. So it's gaining a little bit of heat. In Fantastic Four number 352, there is one panel that shows like Mobius's clone, but doesn't provide who the actual character's name is. So 353 is your first appearance. So that was pretty cool, and I picked this up for a quarter. So you can't go wrong with a quarter. All right, and then the last book, which is going to signify what I call the flea market find of the week. It's none other than, take this out of the bag because it'll look a little better. It's Comic Scenes, number 2. And no barcode, which is pretty cool. This is technically your true first appearance of Venom. When I found this, I had to look this up on my Key Collectors app when it was at the flea market, because this is an older magazine. I saw it here at the bottom. It says Todd McFarlane, 87. So I was like, all right, this has got to have some significance. I looked this up on Key Collector, and it said it was the second appearance of Venom. So I was like, I had to do a little bit of research. I opened up the book. I found the date stamp in there, and it said that it came out 1 month before Amazing Spider-Man 299, which obviously is the first appearance of Venom, not the first full. So I looked inside, and there was some 2 pages worth of Venom's story in here. Oh, sorry, 3 pages. So you see here, shows you that, famous ASM 300 cover. Here on the next page, you see that's that picture of Venom that you see at the, at least his face picture that you see on the back page, like the last page of Amazing Spider-Man 299. So that's really cool. And he is talking there. What's he saying there? He's saying good. So that's pretty cool. And then it has a little bit of talk there from Todd McFarlane that says the reason he has this big demonic smile is because when I first drew Venom, I didn't know that there was a man underneath the alien costume. So let me just zoom in on that, so you guys can see that. So that's a big reveal from, obviously, Todd McFarlane saying that it's Venom. This, like I said, the book came out a month before ASM 299. And he goes into this, further, saying basically here, issue 300 offers more on this. So, multiple panels. And then on the next page, you get your full suit, Eddie Brock showing there with Venom, and some more images there. Really cool. So technically, this is your true first appearance of Venom, and Eddie Brock revealing us Venom. And the funny thing is, I went on to CGC to look up what they classified on this book, and it didn't say anything about second appearance of Venom. Most certainly doesn't say first appearance of Venom, because that's first full is 300, and cameo is 299. But if they went ahead and said that going forward, obviously it would cause a big confusion, because they have over 20,000 graded books alone on CGC for ASM 300 saying that book is the first full appearance. So that's my little spiel on it. To me, this is the true first. It doesn't matter to me. I did have ASM 300 at one point, and I got rid of it. No big deal. And I do have ASM 299 still on my PC. But to me, this is the true first appearance. And most importantly, I'm going to call this my flea market find of the week, because I paid $3 for this book, which is awesome. Awesome score. It's by no means a near mint poppy. There is some spine stress here on the side, as you can see in the angle. But to pay $3 for this pretty significant book, I think it's a pretty big score. Let me know in the comments below what you think about that. So, all right, guys. Until next time, this is Mark Spector Comics. Stay, you know, telling you guys, stay safe out there. Make sure you stock up on your toilet paper. I'm just kidding. But stay safe out there, guys. And until next time, all right, guys, take it easy. Out.